Sometimes in life, don't you wish you could just start over? Well, I have good news for you. If you're a WordPress user, you can start over fresh, and I'm going to show you how in this video. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress tutorial videos for non-techies. If you're new here, consider clicking on the subscribe button. If you don't want to miss a thing, click on the bell off to the right, and YouTube will let you know when I have a new video. All right, so let's just jump into this tutorial. So I have this website right here, and I'm going to be using this for something else, and I want to wipe it out. I want to start over from scratch, and there's some easy ways of doing it. So here's the back end of the WordPress website. Now let me just back it up a little bit and kind of define what starting off from scratch is. So WordPress is a series of files on your web hosting account, and there's also a database. So you have data stored in these two locations. So all of the posts or pages you might create or the settings you configure, those are going to be stored in the database. So that's one thing that needs to get reset, of course. But there's other types of data that you might want to get rid of, and that would be, say, your media files. That's images that you might have uploaded, or if you restored a demo and it downloaded a bunch of images. So that's some stuff, and that's going to be in what's called your uploads folder. Then you might have downloaded some WordPress themes and plugins, and so those are other things that you might have added to your website. So just keep that in mind when I start going through this tutorial. So this site has media, has themes, has plugins, has pages, has posts, and I want to wipe it all out. So all you have to do is go to plugins, click on add new. To save some time, I've already put my search in. I just did a search for the word reset. Now there are quite a few reset plugins for WordPress, and I've been testing them all to find the one that I think is the best, and I found it, and ironically, it just so happens to be the one that has some of the least amount of active installations. And so this video, I'm going to talk about and show you how to use Advanced Reset WP. So I'm going to go ahead and click on install now, and then I will go ahead and activate it. Now all of these reset plugins, once you've downloaded and activated them, they add a new option under tools. So here it is, tools, and then here it is, Advanced Reset WP. So now let's take a look at some of the options, and I'll also explain why I like this one more than the others. So just a moment ago, I was explaining all the different types of data that are in a WordPress website. Now you might want to clear it all out, or you might just want to have a little bit more control over what you reset and start fresh with. Now what this plugin's going to do is you're going to get to choose. Now what it does is it remembers your WordPress login, that's your user account for WordPress, your username and your password. And then once it deletes your database, it recreates that username, so there isn't any friction getting back into your WordPress website. And if you manually installed it, you don't have to go through that process all over again. Now, one of the things that is driving this is I use and test out something called Astra Sites. And so I like to try some of these various demos, and I want to then wipe it out and try a different one. And so that was kind of the driving force behind this, but this is ideal for everyone. Okay, so let's look at the options this is going to give us. Reinstall WordPress. Reinstall Word, that's basically cleaning out the database. Reinstall WordPress and clear the uploads folder. And your uploads folder is where all of your media goes. Post clearing, delete themes, delete plugins, clear uploads folder, deep cleaning. I am just assuming deep cleaning is actually all of the above. So what I recommend you do, and this is how I use it, I click on this box right here, reinstall WordPress. So it's going to clear out your database and your uploads folder. So that's the one I recommend. I don't recommend just the reinstall of WordPress, because you also need that uploads folder cleared out. And that's because if you clean out the database and you don't clean out the uploads folder, WordPress isn't going to know what files are there, even though those files are there. They're just kind of stuck there unless you do some crazy manual stuff that might be a little more work. Anyways, so we're going to choose that option, and then it just lets us know right here. Now, keep in mind, this is 100% destructive. That means it's wiping it out, and there's nothing you're going to be able to do to get any of this back unless you have a backup. Okay. I just said that. Great. All right. Then right here, all you have to do is enter the word reset, and then you can click on start cleaning. Now, it shouldn't take too long. Okay. And this is good. It's giving me a warning. Are you sure you want to do this? And of course, I'm sure I want to do this. I'm going to go ahead and click on okay. Let it do its thing. It's spinning. And you can see off to the right, it said, well, now it's prompting me to log back in, but it said operation results. It cleared out the uploads folder, and then it cleared out the database. And now when I tried this on some other machines, it didn't pop up for me to log in right away. I actually had to refresh the page. So this time it actually did it for me. So you might bump into that. Now all you need to do is log in with your WordPress username and password. Okay, and I've entered that in right now. I'm going to click on login, and let me get this out of the way. And now let me do a quick refresh, and you're going to see everything is cleared out. So when I go to media, my media is going to be empty. When I go to posts, it should just have the default post that every WordPress website starts with. When I click on pages, that should be all cleared out as well. Now, the two things I didn't clear out was my themes and my plugins. However, if I wanted to do that, I like to have a little fine-grained control on it. I can go to appearance and themes. I can use the tool again. I only have this one theme installed. If I go to plugins, it shows me all the plugins, but they're not active. So I can manually delete what I want to delete, or I can go back into the tool and I can go and I can choose the option to clear out all of the plugins. So right here, I can click on delete plugins. And then go ahead, I'm going to enter reset again. And now I'm going to click on start cleaning. And it asks me again, and I click on OK. So whenever you have a premium plugin or theme and you have to enter a license code, that information is stored in the database. So when you clear out the database, it also clears out those license codes, and you may need to re-enter, well, you will need to re-enter them. All right, so it says right here, starting to remove plugins, all 10 plugins removed. So now when I click on plugins, you're going to see that all my plugins have been removed. And that's pretty much all there is to clearing out WordPress and starting fresh. Oh, and last, why don't I just go to the front end here and click on refresh, and you can see everything's been wiped out and I started fresh and new. So this should work with any web hosting provider. It's worked on my local machine. I use a program called Local by Flywheel, and it works great on that as well. And the only place you would probably run into some trouble is obviously if you have your WordPress site on WordPress.com, because that's not your traditional WordPress hosting, and they don't even let you add any of these plugins anyway. So that's it. That's all I have for you in this video. I hope you find it helpful, and thank you for watching. If you found some value, click on the thumbs up, and I'll see you in the next video.